Yes, good morning students. Once again I am meeting you for the subject of principle of communication engineering. I hope during last lecture you might have understood the concepts of modulation, amplitude modulation, frequency modulation, electromagnetic spectrum and other terms relating to communication system, how information can be transmitted from transmitting end towards the receiving end through any communication channel, and channel can be a wireless or it can be with wires. Fine. So before starting the lecture, let me convey you the message of state government captain CM Amrinder Singh ji under Mission Fateh. As you all know, and we all know that presently the entire world is facing this pandemic situation of coronavirus. So we must take all precautionary measures just to avoid from this deadly coronavirus. Keep social distance, avoid social gathering as well. Sanitize your hands with sanitizer so that bacteria, germs may be killed. Fine. And download a COVA app just for yourself, for others as well, so that everybody should be aware of this coronavirus. If somebody is corona positive, you may not be affected by that. So you will get the information through that COVA app. Fine. So keep home, stay at home, keep a social distance, stay healthy, stay safe. Fine. So today, this is a new day of Desi month, Sangrand of Bhado month, you know. So I congratulate to all of you and pray to Almighty that everybody should be blessed by the blessings of the Almighty. So let us start today's lecture, okay? Last time I told you about amplitude modulation, fine, and frequency modulation, phase modulation. So amplitude modulation we have discussed last time, and let me again review the same one. For transmitting information signal, we need another signal, that is a carrier. So information signal is nothing, it is a modulating signal. Look at this figure, and it is also called as baseband signal. It is of low frequency and low power. It is a continuously time varying function with respect to time. Fine. So from zero to here, you know, this is a signal is absent over here, and EM is the amplitude of the baseband or modulating signal. And this is the another signal which is called carrier signal. It is of high frequency and high power. EC is the carrier amplitude. Fine. And this is the signal which is carrying this information, and characteristics of the carrier signal will vary. You know, correct. This is also sinusoidal in nature, baseband signal. And carrier signal is also sinusoidal in nature. And this signal is having three characteristics: amplitude, frequency, and phase. Fine. So three characteristics will vary. If amplitude is being varied with the instantaneous value of the baseband signal or modulated signal, because of its amplitude, the amplitude of this carrier signal is being varied. Look at this at a third figure, modulated signal. Here, where there is a signal is absent, signal is absent, carrier is having no change in its amplitude. But here, this is increasing, and from here, this is decreasing. So here, amplitude is increasing, zero, then negative maximum. Similarly, amplitude of the carrier is also changing in accordance with the amplitude of the instantaneous value of the modulated signal. Fine. So this is an amplitude modulated signal. Okay. This part of the signal is unmodulated because modulated signal is absent over here, and there is no change in the amplitude of the carrier. But wherever the presence of the signal is there, there is a variation in the amplitude of the signal. So this is an amplitude modulated signal. We are calling it as AM wave. And wherever this amplitude is increasing, this amplitude of the carrier is increased by the amplitude of the modulated signal, and it is decreasing over here. So decreased by the amplitude of the modulated signal. carrier is decreased by the amplitude of the modulated signal, and variation of the carrier means information is conveyed by the communication system. But what is the modulation system is? This is amplitude modulated signal, and the modulation is AM modulation. Fine. So let us discuss another type of modulation. Last time it was skipped, and this is frequency modulation. Fine. So frequency modulation means change in frequency of the carrier. Look at this diagram. Okay. Now see, this is the baseband signal again having low frequency and low power, and this is the amplitude of the baseband signal which contains the information. Here, for your simplicity, in the very first figure of the amplitude modulated signal, see, I have shown carrier over here. You know, carrier is here. See, look at this is the carrier, and in frequency modulation system, here, carrier we have not shown just for simplicity. Otherwise, it has to be shown. You know, so how we can expect that what is the which characteristics of the carrier signal will vary? Fine. So here we can draw the carrier signal. In this particular book, it has not been drawn. Fine, no problem. Baseband signal, here it is increasing zero. Then here it is negative maximum. So look at wherever this amplitude is increasing, frequency of the carrier is increasing. But see, here signal is absent. Modulated signal is absent, which contains information, and there is no change in frequency. So no change in the frequency of the carrier. Fine. And the biggest advantage of this is the amplitude of the carrier throughout the signal. It remains same. See, this is the advantage of the frequency modulated signal. Amplitude and phase of this frequency signal will be same. Modulated signal is same. In the previous one, amplitude was varying. Another two characteristics of the carrier signal, frequency signal and frequency of the amplitude modulated signal, and phase of the modulated signal, it is not changed. Only amplitude is changing. Here frequency is changing. See, wherever amplitude is increasing, it is increasing. If it is decreasing over here, modulating signal, the amplitude is decreasing over here. Look at, there are less number of cycles, so minimum frequency. But see, frequency is being changed, whether it is increased or decreased. So there is a change, and this variation in frequency means information is conveyed. Fine. So this is frequency modulation. Fine. This is a deviation in frequency. How much frequency of the carrier signal is deviated from its original value? Fine. So I will tell you the other concepts of the frequency modulation. This is the third category of phase modulation. Look at, again, for your simplicity, in this particular book, it has not drawn the carrier, but it is understood. You have to draw the carrier. Carrier I have shown in the first figure of AM. Fine. See, again, amplitude modulated signal, and look at, this is looking like FM. See, this is looking like FM, because here signal is frequency of the signal is it is carrier is it is stretching, then phase is lagging, you know, so less number of cycles. But see here, where there is a change from maximum to zero, then to negative maximum, there is a maximum change. See, let me tell you how we can get the frequency modulated signal, phase modulated signal. So here we have to talk in terms of phase. Phase means angle. So this original modulated signal, it is already shifted by 90 degree. So of course, fine, this, in fact, there is a change in phase, and phase is with respect to the change in the carrier, frequency of the carrier. So we can even have frequency modulated from the phase modulated signal. We will discuss in case of FM modulators next chapters, in the coming days as well. Fine. So this is how frequency, phase of the carrier is changed. It is modulated. Fine. It is modulated. So phase of the carrier is modulated. There is a change in the phase variations of the carrier. So information is conveyed. Fine. So these are the three analog modulation techniques: amplitude modulated signal, frequency modulated signal, and of course, this is the phase modulation. I hope you understood the concepts of three types of modulations. Okay. This again, I told you last time, what is PAM, PWM, PM? Here, see, basement signal is same. This is sinusoidal in nature. This is a information signal or modulating signal. But here, carrier is different. It is in the form of pulses and number of pulses per second. That is a its pulse rate or pulse frequency. I mean, this is called sampling frequency. So sampler is a circuit. You will study in the last chapters of this particular book. What is sampling? What are PAM, PWM, and PPM? What is how this sampling frequency or these pulses in the for sampling frequency or these this is the carrier in terms of pulses, how it will be generated. So that we will discuss in the last chapters of this book. But meanwhile, you can remember how this particular carrier is looking like that. So these are the pulses of this carrier. Now, wherever this amplitude is increasing, see amplitude of these pulses is also being changed. Look at, this is a natural PAM, you know, natural as the signal is being, you know, as signal is changing, same way the amplitude of the pulses are also being changed. So this is a natural PAM, you know, a natural sampling technique. We are getting as this baseband signal is looking like that, so it is also looking in the same way. That is why it is called natural. I will let you know while sampling what kind of sampling, what is natural sampling, what is ideal sampling, what is flat sampling. That we will discuss in the last chapter of this book. Fine. So meanwhile, you just remember. So what is being varied? Here amplitude is being varied. So this is pulse amplitude modulated signal. Then in the next one, it is, look at here, width is this one, the width is this one. Look at here, width is small. So where width is increasing, amplitude of the, it is increasing, the width of the pulse is increasing in accordance with the amplitude of the modulated signal. So if amplitude of the modulated signal is increasing, width of the pulse is also increasing. This is pulse width modulated signal. I mean, if there is a change in the width of the pulse, information is conveyed. And category is PWM. And in case of PPM, for it is not shown over here, but position of the pulse is being changed. So that is why if position of the pulse will be changed in accordance with the amplitude of the modulated signal, it means this is PPM and information is conveyed accordingly. Fine. These are also the category of analog modulation, but this is termed as pulse analog modulation. Fine. Okay. Now, already told you in the beginning of the lecture, I mean, in the previous, I told you what type of modulation systems are there. Those can be analog and digital also. So analog we discussed. And what is digital modulation techniques? This is PCM and DM. PCM means pulse code modulation. And DM is delta modulation. So this we are also calling as digital pulse modulation system. Here train of digital pulses is transmitted by the transmitter. Fine. And that I will let you know in the last chapters of this book. But meanwhile, you just remember this is a digital modulation techniques. This is quite better than the analog modulation technique. Quality of the signal is much better. But here we have to sample the original signal, which is analog in nature. Then we have to pass it through the quantizer so that approximated or round up signal we can get have. So first original signal, which is analog, then we have to make samples with the help of sampling frequency at the rate of twice. Nyquist criterion we have to follow. Then original signal, then quantize. Then it has to pass through the encoder. You are getting a digitized output. Fine. And delta modulation is another digital modulation technique. Advanced version of PCM is DPCM, differential pulse code modulation. And advanced version of delta modulation is adaptive delta modulation. We will discuss all those in the last chapter of this book. And it is quite clear that digital communication is quite is far far better than analog communication, analog modulation techniques, because look at here, they are offering higher noise immunity than the analog communication system. So this is a bigger advantage, and moreover, information is contained in the combination of pulses or in the form of codes. Fine, we can get at the output end of the digital system. Fine, of course. But if we are getting a good quality of signal, that is expense of the bandwidth, because digital communications systems, in digital we are sending the pulses in the form of digital signal, in the form of message or discrete or symbols, that were from there we can have bits, you know. So how many number of bits per second have been transmitted, that decide the data rate of the particular system. And bits per second, that is bit rate, and it is depending upon the bandwidth of the system. I will tell you later. Meanwhile, you can remember that these systems are offering less noise. I mean, they are having more noise immunity as compared to analog communication system. In analog communication system, once noise added, it cannot be suppressed or it cannot be eliminated completely, but it can be controlled somehow by using different techniques. Fine. But in digital communication system, if somehow, because signal is passing in the form of ones or zeros, you know, zero ones. So somewhere if zero is being changed by one or one is being changed by zero, this is a error. And then first, by introducing some circuitry in the form of parity, you know, or other circuitry, that can detect the error first, then it can correct, and finally it will be transmitted toward the receiving end. So we can, in digital communication, we can detect the error as well as correct the error. That is why they are immune to noise. Fine. Of course, digital communication are having number of advantages. Fine. Due to the digital nature of the transmitted signal, the interference of additive noise does not introduce many errors. So digital communication system has a better noise immunity. Just discussed, I told you. Fine. Another is, digital communications are also using channel coding techniques. Fine. And in channel coding techniques, it is possible to detect and correct the errors introduced during the data transmission. Fine. So that is why we are using channel coding techniques. Of course, if you want to convey the information up to a large distance, repeaters or regenerator can be used between transmitter and receiver. So what is the role of the repeater or regenerator? It will receive the signal, it will regenerate it, it will modify it, amplify it, and then it will improve the noise immunity further and will be transmitted toward the receiving end. Fine. So this is the role of the repeaters, and repeater can be introduced between transmit and receiver so that long distance digital communication can be possible. And fourth advantage is, digital nature of the signal, because of the digital, it is possible to use advanced data processing techniques such as digital signal processing, image processing, and data compression. These are advanced data processing techniques. With this, we can improve the performance of the systems. Of course, multiplexing is also possible in case of digital communication. Here, TDM, time division multiplexing technique, that can be used to transmit many voice channels over a single communication channel. Fine. But here, information can be divided into time slots. That we will discuss while talking multiplexing in the second last chapter of this book. Fine. Digital communication is useful in military communication, where only a few permitted receivers can receive the transmitted signal. Because, you know, military, of course, there is a one point that is called security. So information is transmitted in the form of coded, you know, coded signal is transmitted. Encryption is the word which introduces security. Fine. So digital communication can be more secured, and military needs such applications where few permitted receivers are allowed to receive the transmitted signal. Fine. Digital communication is becoming simpler and economical or cheaper as compared to the analog communication due to the inventions of high-speed computers and integrated circuits, ICs. You know, this is an era of digital communication, and the mission of this country, I mean, under as the message of the Prime Minister, that I want to make this country a digital India. So, of course, as I am teaching you, these are the digital communication techniques. I am using this technique. These are the digital communication techniques. So this is online technique. Fine. Of course, if this system is having some advantages, disadvantages are also there. And disadvantages of the digital communication are nothing, but you know, bit rates of digital systems are high, as I already told you. They require large channel width as compared to analog communication system. So channel bandwidth is more is required in case of digital communication system. This is, and of course, between transmitting and receiving end, we need synchronization. For that, additional circuitry is required. So synchronous modulation is required. So this is, if we have to receive the good quality of the signal, we have to increase the channel bandwidth because of the high bit rate of the digital system. And of course, synchronization at both end, transmitting and receiving end, it is required. So additional, circuit is required for synchronous modulation or for the requirement of the synchronization at transmitting and receiving end. Fine. So this is how I have shown the comparison between the two modulation, analog and digital modulation. Let us go through quickly. Transmitted modulated signal is analog in nature. Here it is digital in nature, and digital signal is nothing. This is train of digital pulses. Amplitude, frequency, and phase variations in the transmitted signal represent the information or message. Already told you in three kind of analog modulation techniques. Here amplitude, width, and position is a transmitted pulses is constant. Message is a transmitted in the form of code words. So this is different. Fine. Noise minute in AM is very poor. FM it is improved, and even PM, but noise amenity among three, these three modulations, AM, FM, and PM, FM is far better than AM and PM. So noise amenity in AM system is very poor. You know, you are listening radio on the medium wave, so you are not getting good quality of signal. But if you are tuning through the FM, you know, 98.3, 94.3, 102.7, Rainbow channel or Mirchi channel, you are getting good quality of signal because frequency range is much, and this is more immune to noise. But in digital system, they are very good system and highly immune to noise. That is why they are termed as excellent communication systems. So here in case of analog communication system, once noise added cannot be eliminated. So it's not possible to use to separate out noise and signal. Repeaters are not allowed over here. So here repeaters are allowed, which can improve the performance of the signal, or it can improve the noise as well. It can immune the noise. Here in analog communication, less bandwidth is required, but due to higher bit rates, higher channel bandwidths are required or needed in case of digital communication. Multiplexing FDM in analog, TDM in digital. So analog modulations are not suitable for transmission of secret information in military, but here due to the coded techniques, it can be suitable for military application. And these are the various analog modulation techniques, AM, FM, PM, PAM, PWM, even PPM. So in digital modulation, PCM, DC, DM, pulse code modulation, delta modulation, adaptive delta modulation, definition pulse code modulation, even in higher classes, you will study amplitude shift keying, frequency shift keying, PSK, BPSK, fine, QPSK. Those are the higher digital modulation techniques, fine. And system is going on improved, fine, by using different digital modulation techniques, fine. Demodulation or detection is just a reverse process of transmission or modulation or transmission, fine. So in demodulation or detection means signals are detected. It means by the transmitter, all those modulated signals are transmitted through air medium or wire medium, and they can reach the receiver by traveling over the communication medium, fine. So at the receiving end, we have to demodulate it. And in digital, this is again repeated, fine. Next, comparison we have just gone through. Demodulation means at the receiving end, we are getting a regional information signal, which can be separated from the carrier, okay? So this process is called demodulation or detection, and it is exactly a reverse opposite process of modulation. Let us go through the quickly applications of communication system. There is no any such field where this communication is not required. Majority of the applications are there. It is depending upon, radio, telephone, and televisions. They are the most common applications. Fine. Other communications are like cellular. You are using mobile phones. You are using radios, citizen band radios, pagers. That was the old technology. Nowadays, it is not there. Remote controls are being used. That is also the application of the communication. So let us go through quickly, depending upon the what kind of communication system we are using. If we are using a simplex or duplex, let me show you the applications. In simplex, AM, FM broadcasting is possible. This is one way only. TV broadcasting is also one way. Cable TV is also one way. Facsimile transmission in fax, that is also one way. And wireless remote control, that is also simplex system, one way communication. Pagers, nowadays it is not available. Around 10-15 years back, it was, but it is a one way communication. Navigation and direction finding, especially in case of radar, fine, and in case of air traffic control system, ACS. So this is one way. Telemetry, that is used in satellite communication where earth stations are getting information from the telemetry. So this is one way only. It is telling the positions of the satellite, what is the temperature, what is the position of the satellite. Radio astronomy, surveillance, teletext, view data, and music services, all those are simplex and one-way communication system. Two-way duplex system, bi-directional telephones, you can talk simultaneously, you can transmit as well as receive. So two-way radio is nowadays, it is possible. Radar, that is also sonar, sound navigation and ranging. Radar means radio detection and ranging. Amateur radio, citizens radio. So data communications, local networks, all are two-way communications. So comes under duplex, two-way communication systems. So this, as I already told you, for studying any engineering, communication engineering subject, you have to become familiar with the electromagnetic spectrum. This is nothing but a range from low frequency range, extremely low frequency range, up to high frequency range. In principle of communication engineering, we will talk about radio waves, we will talk about medium waves. I can let you know, let us become familiar with the communication electromagnetic spectrum. Here, this dot is a frequency. This arrow, frequency is increasing, multiples of 10, 30 hertz, from hertz, then multiply by 10, 300, multiply by 10, 3000, that is 3K, again 30K, 300K, 3000, 3 megahertz, then 30 megahertz, then 300 megahertz, 3 giga, 30 giga, and 300 giga. So, with the relation of lambda is equal to C by F, or F is equal to C by lambda. With that, if frequency is increasing, wavelength is decreasing. Look at, frequency is less, but wavelength, look at. It is in lakhs of kilometers. So as you are increasing the frequency, wavelength is decreasing. The entire frequency spectrum, electromagnetic spectrum is divided into, in broad categories, divided into three ranges, low, medium, and high frequency ranges. Fine. So these are the various bands of the electromagnetic spectrum. Extremely low frequency, then voice frequency, very low frequency, medium frequency, high frequency. This is VHF, very high frequency, ultra high frequency, super high frequency, extremely high frequency. And beyond that, millimeter waves are there. Then this light region is starting from infrared, then visible spectrum, then ultraviolet. After that, X-rays, gamma rays, and cosmic rays, fine. So this entire becomes electromagnetic spectrum. This here, in PC, you will become familiar with this range, from few hertz to few mega. But in higher classes, as you will jump fourth sem, fifth sem, and sixth sem, you will become the higher range. You have to become with the higher range of the frequency in electromagnetic spectrum. I mean radio waves, then microwave, then a light region. Fine. So based on this frequency range, accordingly systems are designed. Communication systems are designed, like microwave radio system, optical fiber communication system. They are using this range. Fine. And FM using, you know, a few 88 megahertz to 88 megahertz to 100. Yes, 8 from 88 to 108 megahertz. That is the FM, and bandwidth is 20 megahertz. So this is used in this particular region, VHF. Fine. And the TV is also used in VHF and as well as UHF. Fine. So TV is also communication system. Radio is also a communication system, and of course microwave radio system, that is a communication system. Optical fiber communication system, that is a optical communication. Means it has to follow some system is required, that is optical fiber system communication system. But here transmission medium is physical material medium, that is optical fiber. Fine. So how this electromagnetic spectrum is divided into various segments, that is look at. As I just mentioned, starting from extremely low frequency to voice frequency, very low, then low frequency, medium frequency, high frequency, very high frequency, ultra, super, extremely high, then a light regions. Accordingly, frequency is increasing, wavelength is decreasing. This is what I told you just now. Fine. And what is frequency? Number of cycles per second, that you have already studied. And wavelength is nothing. Wavelength in frequency can be measured in terms of kilohertz, megahertz, gigahertz. 1 kilo means 10 to the power 3 or 1000 hertz. 1 mega means 1000 kilohertz or 1 into 10 to the power 6 hertz. 1 giga means 1000 megahertz or 10 to the power 9 hertz. These are the units of the frequency. 1 cycle means it is taking, this is the cycle of a wave. I mean, if there is 1 cycle in 1 second, that is 1 hertz. 1000 cycles in 1 second, 1000 hertz. Fine. 10 lakh seconds in 1 hertz, I mean in 1 second, 1 megahertz. 100 crore cycles in 1 second means that is 1 gigahertz. Fine. And wavelength is, that is lambda is equal to C by F. So wavelength is nothing here. It is a distance between two successive crests or troughs. Or wave is starting from this end, how much distance it is covering for completing a 1 cycle. That is a wavelength. This is 1 wavelength. So distance between two successive crest or trough, that is a wavelength. So look at lambda can be calculated as, it can be 3 speed of the light over frequency. So this way wavelength we can calculate. Fine. These are applications are also depending upon the frequency range. Fine. Let us go through quickly what are the this is radio frequency spectrum and divided into various frequency bands, wavelength, and look at the applications area. Extremely low frequency applications, at extremely low frequency you can expect large power, you know, our transmission lines and domestic power supply. You are getting AC supply 220 volt. It can be 440 volt. It can be 33K also, 66K also. Fine. But frequency range will be 50 hertz. So we can expect more power. And power transmission is the one of the major application of the communication at low frequency. Then frequency is bit increased. Audio is the audio application is this particular frequency range. Then samurai communication, navy, military communication. It is coming in 3 kilohertz to 30 kilohertz. Fine. And this is also the range of voice frequency. For making a telephone call, we have to use this particular frequency. 300 hertz to 3 kilohertz or 3000 hertz. Fine. And look at frequency is increasing, wavelength is decreasing. Accordingly, Applications are also being changed depending on the frequency range. See, aeronautical, marine, navigation, these frequencies are acting as subcarriers for these applications. And look at the frequency range, 30 kilohertz to 300 kilohertz. Fine. Then another applications are now, this is 300 kilohertz to 30 megahertz. So radio broadcasting range, this is medium frequency, we are calling it as, and wavelength is decreased. So AM radio broadcasting, marine and aeronautical communications applications are possible in this frequency range. You are increasing the frequency. This is high frequency, 3 megahertz to 30 megahertz. And look at the wavelength, it is also decreasing. And applications is short wave transmission. Fine. There is a short wave band in radio as well. Amateur and citizen band radios are all the applications of high frequency communications. Fine. Then 30 megahertz to 300 megahertz wavelength is decreased. Applications are TV broadcasting and FM broadcasting. Look at, so these are the high frequency applications. Again, fine. I hope you understand the concept of electromagnetic spectrum, frequency ranges, various bands, and various application depending upon the frequency ranges. And if you are increasing the more frequency, it is from 300 megahertz to 3 gigahertz. Look at the applications. UHF TV channels, cellular phones, and military communications. Fine. Then 3 gigahertz to 30 gigahertz and satellite communication and radar, again 30 to 300 gigahertz, wavelength is decreased. Look at satellite and special radars are the applications of this frequency band EHF. Infrared signals, these are the light signals. You know, there are three regions of light regions in electromagnetic spectrum: infrared, visible spectrum, and ultraviolet. So, beyond 3 gigahertz, this is not termed as radio waves. I mean, light frequencies beyond 3 gigahertz are light frequencies. And the wavelength is varying from 0.1 millimeter to 700 nanometers. So for infrared signals, these are used in various special kind of communication like in astronomy to detect star and other heavenly bodies, you know, celestial bodies, we can say. For guidance and weapon systems, and for TV remote control as well. Whenever you are switching on and off, while switching on your TV or me, switching off your TV, you are using a remote now, it is generating infrared signals, fine? And that is the light signal. Visible light is coming in the range of visible spectrum, varying from 0.4 micrometer to 0.8 micrometer, or 400 nanometer to 800 nanometer, fine. So this particular frequency range or wavelength range is used for various kinds of application, fine, visible spectrum. So light waves can be modulated and transmitted through glass fibers and the optical fiber communications. Already told you, light is a major carrier because frequency in terms of terahertz, and optical fiber is the material medium which can allow the light as a signal. It is acting as a carrier, it is carrying information and frequency in terms of terahertz, so huge bandwidth, and it is carrying lakhs number of channels, fine. So thousand numbers of lakhs of users can be accommodated through fiber communication system. That is why nowadays all the communication systems are based on optical fiber, fine. Then light signals can be transmitted through free space, but through free space, it will be attenuated shortly because of the presence of the water vapors, other gaseous particulates that can be. So through optical fiber, this communication is possible. Fine. Beyond visible light or ultraviolet spectrum, X-ray, gamma rays, and cosmic rays are there, but they are not useful for communication purposes. Bandwidth is nothing. This is a portion of the electromagnetic spectrum occupied by the signal. Fine. I mean, like how much particular system is required a bandwidth for communicating the signal. So more the bandwidth, more the information carrying capacity of the communication system. Fine. Now look at, if I will, for audio range, see it is starting from 20 hertz to say 20 kilohertz or 15 kilohertz. Now upper cutoff minus lower cutoff, that tells the bandwidth of this particular audio. Look at, upper cutoff is 15,000 hertz. or 15 kilohertz, and lower one is 20 hertz. So almost it is almost equal to 15,000 hertz or 15k. 14,980 is near to 15k. Fine. So this way bandwidth can be calculated, and this is this part of the this is nothing but it's a frequency range which can occupy the some portion of the electromagnetic spectrum. Fine. Now let me tell you the various different signals. What are their bandwidths? See, voice signal, it is calling as speech of the telephony as well. So look at the frequency range, 300 to 3400 hertz. Upper minus lower, 3100 hertz. Fine, this is the bandwidth in hertz for telephony signals or voice signal. Music signal, it varies from 20 hertz to 15,000 hertz. Upper minus lower, that is 14,980 hertz. TV signals, 0 to 5 megahertz, upper minus lower, this is 5 megahertz. And digital data, if it is used for telephone line for its transmission, but communication data is digital. So again, frequency range is this frequency, I mean 300 to 3400 hertz, and bandwidth is upper minus lower, 3100 or 3.1 kilohertz. Fine, nah? So this is how the bandwidth of the different signals. Fine, frequency spectrum and electromagnetic spectrum we have already discussed. Channel bandwidth, and that is this is nothing but range of frequency that contain the information is called bandwidth. But the term channel bandwidth is used to describe the range of frequency required to transmit the desired information. How much range of frequency, how much bandwidth is required to transmit the desired information, that is called channel bandwidth. Fine, now for example, for amplitude modulation AM system, which are being operated at medium wave, they need the channel bandwidth of 10 kilohertz, fine, and to transmit a signal of 5 kilohertz, you know, bandwidth. But single side system that we will discuss in the coming chapters, that needs only 5 kilohertz channel bandwidth to transmit only same signal, because only one single sideband system is required. All the efforts should be made to reduce the required channel bandwidth so that we can fit the more number of channels in the same available electromagnetic spectrum. This is how efficiently we can use the bandwidth offered by the electromagnetic spectrum. Fine. You can go through. So I hope you enjoyed the lecture. Fine. So I told you in the previous lecture and today's lecture about the basic concepts of communication. What is basic communication system? What is modulation? What is the need of modulation? What are the various modulation system? How modulation systems can be classified? Simplex, half duplex, analog or digital, and analog and digital modulation system. Briefly, I described you, and then I have made you familiar with the electromagnetic communication spectrum, electromagnetic spectrum, which is covering the entire frequency range, and how all those frequency ranges are being divided into different bands, and how all those different bands are meant for different kinds of electronics communication. So go through these some review questions, which are fill in the blanks, multiple choice questions, and some test questions. I hope you enjoyed the lecture. Fine. Good day. Thank you very much.